Adam. Thank you for taking the time to meet up with me today. Can you just tell a little bit about your life before you became a Muslim?
Before I came to Semenanjung, I was in Sabah for until I was 4 months. The first time I heard about Islam is in when I was standard 3. When I moved out of my kampung lah in Sabah, which is that kampung is only mostly Christian. So I moved to a community where it's quite diverse, different race like Bajau, Kadazan, all these Malays. So when I come to the school in this new area, the community, my first reaction was this writing in the school. The writing was in Jawi. So I asked one of my friends, are we going to study that in school? And he said yes. I was like, okay, because I never been to a place where there's Muslim before. My friend was most of my friends are Muslim. Then I came here to Semenanjung when I was 13. Again, I went to a school where there's plenty of Muslim. There is a time when I think it's during puasa. So during lunchtime, I don't go eat because I want to hang out with them. So I was quite a big kid, you know. I fat chubby lah, chubby. And then because of that fasting, I lose weight lah.
Wow.
Yeah, I lose weight because of the fasting. So it encouraged me more to continue fasting. As you go along with your Muslim friend, you get become close with them and you get to know, you know, I'm doing what I've been doing as a Muslim. So there's this thought that coming into my mind that you know, maybe I want to be Muslim. yes, maybe I want to be become Muslim. I want to learn about Islam more. Went for my college. During this period, I have not really got close to Islam as much as I wanted to, because, you know, obviously you want to focus more on studying and everything, you know. So until I started working, I was doing my practical. This is where I met my future wife lah. Obviously she's a Muslim. Okay, you know, get to know her, and then decide to get married. All this time, I was 50-50. I just wanted to be a Muslim. I just need that something to really push me, you know, to be a Muslim. I still need to think about my parents, right? If I become Muslim, and what would they think about me? Again, this during before we did, me and my future wife, my wife now, before we decide to get married.
Oh, you are married now already.
Yeah, married now already.
Okay.
Married now already. When I decide to be a Muslim, I went to the Jawi, Jabatan Agama Islam, Wilayah Pencegahan. Yeah, I went there. We just want to start, and you know, I did my shahadah there. And then become a Muslim.
How did it feel after you said shahada?
It's something I cannot describe. You know, when I did my shahada, it's somehow it afflicts me in I cannot describe what the feeling. It's like my
that goosebumps.
Yeah. I have that goosebumps and everything is like, and then feel like crying as well. Yeah,
would say that Islam was within you for
long time already, and then
you had
finally the day came to me, and then I was like, I was teary, but I feel very happy to do it.
What's your favorite part in Ramadan?
Favorite part in Ramadan is I say Ishtar Alam. Me and my wife and two kids. Thank you. My sister-in-law live nearby as well.
Okay.
So every month of Ramadan, so she cook during month of Ramadan. So every day during, you know, when you need to break your fast, we come to her house, mm-hmm. and then she cook for us. The reason why that is my favorite part is because one, because she cook good food. Okay. And then second is it's because she also got her own family. Mm. Yeah, her husband's there, the kids also over there. So it is a sense of gathering as a family during this Ramadan. You get to spend time with them. Yeah.
That's why you enjoy the
experience. Yes. This experience which I never got experience before this. Since I become a Muslim, the relation as a family, I just realized how much of togetherness as a family you can be really are.
I'm just curious, why did you choose the name Adam though?
Adam. Adam, because Adam for me is like a beginning.
Okay.
It's like our Nabi Adam is the first Nabi.
Correct.
Okay. And once you revert to Islam, to Muslim, you are like a newly born baby.
Yeah.
For me, it's a feeling that it's not a new identity, but it's a new beginning for me.
Okay, alright, thank you Adam for sharing your experience. Thank you so much.